We are all unique, and thus we like to name our variables in unique ways using unique styles. Some people like the good old camel case for everything, you know. Some people like Haskell case if they're feeling a little bit more capital, or if they come from C-sharp, because C-sharp loves that. Some people like snake case, you know, if you're from Python or Rust or something like that, because Rust actually makes you. Some people like snake case, and some people like the really cursed case. I don't know why you would ever use this. This should never be used. And the age-old question is, what is the right way to name your variables? How should you make your style? And today, ladies and gentlemen, I have an answer. Because I was browsing the Roblox documentation, and this is what it says. It says, you know, you spell out your words fully, yeah, yeah, yeah. And it also says, use Pascal case for class and enum-like objects. Use Pascal case names for Roblox APIs. That's all, like, guaranteed, basically. Camel case for local variables, member values, and functions. And allow snake case for constants. So what we see here is a guide on the official Roblox website telling you how to name your variables. I mean, you might be saying, well, we are individual programmers. We should be able to choose what we want. And I tell you no. If you don't like this and make your own thing, it's going to make it less readable for someone who does. So I say we need to start a movement to make sure everyone standardize their variable naming. Because no matter if you like the way this looks, no matter what your personal preferences are, if you follow the conventions established by the platform that you're using, it will make everyone's lives easier. For example, in Rust, Rust uses snake case, and the linter, the thing that like checks to make sure your code looks good, will yell at you if you're not in snake case. So you see this red underline here? And Rust, even if you have like a camel case variable, it'll underline your variable and be like, hey, change it to snake case. But in Roblox, snake case isn't even a thing unless you're dealing with constants with loud snake case. So you gotta decide, and by decide I mean choose the right path of using these guides to actually name your variables, because that will lead to the best coding experience for everyone overall. For me personally, I adapt to my environment, and I think this is the best way to do it. Whatever the best practices say in your company, in your ecosystem, in your personal project with friends, that's what you should follow. In Roblox, I tend to stick to this, or in the past, I've used Pascal case for functions, but now we're going to change that. And for Rust, I use snake case. For Python, I use snake case because that's what everyone uses. For C Sharp, I use Pascal case for everything because that's how Microsoft wants it. For Java, you use camel case for mostly everything except for classes, and that's just what I do. So before you make your next project, your next script, your next little thing, remember to look at your requirements, look at your best practices, and I encourage you to follow them. That way, your code will be readable to all. And trust me, if you're not used to it, you don't like it, you'll get used to it over time, and you'll have the comfort in the back of your mind knowing that you made the right decision. And that's it. Thanks for watching.